sorts of things. Well, the fact is, he's actually a deacon in a church, a pastor in a church, and he is telling me I'm a horrible person going to hell. Now, I would like to know why is it okay for someone, you know, to use their religion against people who are different than our, you know, gay people.
And oh my gosh, is that not a huge thing in the Bible Belt or what? Because that is one of the biggest things that I come across living where I live, that, oh, it's a sin, it's a sin, it's a sin. And what I tell people is, well, judging someone is a sin too. You can't judge someone. Only God can. So I was fortunate enough to, even though my mother came from a situation with some of her family members, like her grandma, my great-grandma, who was anti-gay and you have to go to church and a lot of other stuff, I grew up with a mother who, we didn't go to church. We did say the blessing. We understood, you know, who God was and Jesus was and things like that. But my mother was very lenient. You know, she was basically under the understanding, like, if I were to come to her, you know, at 16 years old and said, Mom, I want to be Jewish, she'd have been like, well, okay, you know. well, as long as you believe in something,
it wasn't
a huge
deal.
Okay.
Right.
It wasn't a strict Christian, you have to believe in this or you're going to hell. My mother has never been like that. And I always tell everybody, like, I've literally got the best mother in the world. And
you're lucky you're lucky to be a Southerner and have that kind of a parent. My mother never had a problem with me, really. I mean, she's been fine. And she loves me to death, and I love her. But it was just my dad.
If I
came out when I was 14.
My mom would have been fine with it.
Yeah, exactly. And my mom was fine with it too. I came out when I was 14, and she was, at first she was like, oh, she's like, you know, getting over the shock of it, but she was okay after that, and she's been fine. We're very close.
See, my parents was like that. I'm sorry to cut you off.
I'm done.
I mean, I wish my parents was like that, but at the same time, I went through a lot of other stuff too in my home, and I had to realize, older, me and my mom, we're trying to get over it. And we're like, I let the past go because I can't live in the past. But like I've told her before, I always loved her because my mom is my mom. And I know why she did what she did. And I'm not mad at her because I told her that's how you was raised. That's the mentality you have. And that's what you are. So I can't be upset with you because of what you believe in, because what you believe in, that's what you're believed in. I can't say, I don't love my mom because she
I disagree with that. You know why I disagree with that? And this is why. I have no problem with people having their own belief systems, and whether it's Christian or Jew or whatever, or religion or whatever, even if it's just a belief system that they've been passed down that has nothing to do with religion, whatever. That you can believe whatever you want, that's fine. The difference is when your belief system prevents you from seeing things logically or rationally, and you're blinded by blind faith, that's an issue for me. And it also becomes an issue when you reach your hand into my life and say, and try to prevent me from having equality and try to curtail my equality, my legal rights or whatever, because you don't agree with them. It's one thing to disagree with me and have your beliefs. It's another to try to curtail my rights as a citizen or a human being even. So that's where I have a disconnect. So when people say, well, it's your belief, whatever, yeah, you believe whatever you want, well, that's fine, you can, but it's not okay to say to someone else that you have to believe the way I believe, or, you know, you don't get the same rights I have. I'm sorry, that's just wrong. So I don't agree that it's okay.
And that's so true because, I'm sorry, I'll let you talk, Reeve. I've been talking a lot. I'm sorry.
Oh, no, you're fine. I was just going to say, you know, where all this controversy comes up with do the gay people have rights? Can they get married? Can they do this? Can they do that? I'm like, well, to be honest, not to try to offend anybody, but I really don't give two shits about what
you're going
to
marry a gay person, are you? Are you going to marry a gay person? No. So why the hell would you give a shit?
Well, and to be honest, I don't really care. And some people might get offended that I don't give two shits about you, but I really don't give two shits the fact that you're gay or you want to get married or whatever, because that has no effect on me whatsoever. So I just live my life as I don't really give two shits of what you did.
That's fine.
I don't understand why other people let it bother them.
Exactly. That's my point. What the fuck does it matter?
I actually agree with you, Ray.
Not Ray.
Not Ray.
I'm sorry. Ray, I do actually agree with you because of that. A lot of people don't. Why do you care who I prefer to be with? Because, and I've learned this, and I always tell people this, I want to be happy. And if I want to be with a man, then let me be happy. Because I'm not judging you because you don't want to be married. I do. Like, everyone wants, I mean, a lot of people that talk about, oh, I don't believe in marriage, or I don't like gay men getting married. Well, you're not married, so why are you talking about it? You just might not want, my man don't want to marry you. That's why you're mad. That's why you're telling me.
Hey, look, I'm married.
You're mad. You're not, and I'm not saying you, but I'm just saying in general, like, you're not, because a lot of people, a lot of women have told me they don't believe in gay marriage, they're not married. So I'm like, oh, you're mad because you're never going to find a lover or a husband to marry you. That's why
all
you don't
those
want
men are gay.
Look, I'm married. I'm married, and if you want to get into that same battle-ass commitment that I'm in, then so be it.
I'm married, too.
I'm going to go ahead and tell you what you're in for.
Yeah, I'm married.
Because me and my husband, I love my husband to death, yes, but sometimes I want to kill him. You know?
My husband and I got married in 2009 in Connecticut. And because we got married in Connecticut. Oh, yeah. We've been there for 6 years, 6.5 years. But anyway, we got married in Connecticut.
Oh.
And we live in Texas, though. So it doesn't mean anything. It's just that we're married. And this is all we want, is to have equality. We want to have the same rights. We want the federal government to recognize our marriage because that means we get all the same the rights in terms of taxes and taxation and like you're talking about the hospital and things like that without having to draw up all these fucking lawyer papers and shit. And so all we want is the same rights.
The thing is,
we are in this limbo because the government, the federal government, doesn't recognize it because of the DOMA, the Defense of Marriage Act, which is still there, and the states won't recognize it that aren't allowing gay marriage. And so we're okay in Connecticut or any of the states pretty much that allow gay marriage, but we're not okay if we live in our own state or our home and we pay taxes. And we pay taxes. This still pisses me off. We pay taxes, pay property taxes out the wazoo. And do we have equality? No. We pay the IRS. Do we have equality? No. So we're paying same amount of taxes all of you are, and you all get, those you meaning the heterosexuals, you all get all these rights, thousands of rights, because you're heterosexual. But because we're not heterosexual, we don't get the same, even though we put the same amount of money into the system. That is not fair. That is inequality.
Hey, what do you think about the whole...
Go ahead.
Go ahead.
Oh, no, I was saying that I agree with you because that is, I say that we should have the same rights because of, we're Americans, we were born in America, we fought, we pay everything, do everything everyone else do, why can't we get what we want?
Exactly.
Why can't we do it? It reminds me, it makes me, like I said earlier, it makes me feel like we're back, and I have told someone this before. The style, like 4 or 5 years ago, everybody was dressed like the 60s. And I said to someone, everyone's going back to the mentality to the 60s. He said, no, we're not. I said, yes, we are. Because a lot of people are trying to get the I call it a white picket fence life. Meaning the house, the kids, and the car. Everyone wants that now. They don't want to just be independent. Girls want to be married. And I've never heard a lot of steam about being married and having a husband. And everyone's talking about doing so much now, like we were in the 60s. And I feel like we're going back in the 60s mentally. Like, we can't get married because you're gay. Okay. Well, let's go back to 1970s when gay people were disco and partying and everything was fashionable for gays. Let's go back there. Because was it more better for gay people to get married in the 80s? Like, and that was a lot of gay people was very fashionable in the 80s. Like, but we're trying to do it now because it's really regular now. It's time for us to do it. So can we get a mentality now? You know where I'm trying to come from? Like, is we need to come out of the mentality that gay people or there's people. There's one thing I hate. I have to say this one thing, and I'm gonna say I'm finished. I hear so many people say gay people are like diseases, and that's why we don't receive the things everyone else receives. And I hate that, and I tell anyone this, I'll forgive my language, because you are a lady. Fuck that, because straight people have diseases too. They
you don't have to worry about me, honey, because I have a sailor mouth.
No, I mean, but you're still a lady, and I was told I'm from the South, and you're still a lady, and I'm going to respect the woman. She's in prison.
I'm one of those certain individuals that I cuss more than the normal man does. I've got one of those dirty mouths, and I say fuck you more than my husband probably does. And if you don't cuss a little bit while I talk to you, then I really don't feel a bond to you. So,
but you feel where I'm coming from, right? When I say it, like,
yeah, I do. I do. I think that's of course we do. And I think that unfortunately, that's the thing, is that we no longer live in the 50s or the 60s or whatever, the queer era, whatever you want to call it, or the Brady Bunch era. We don't live in that time anymore. And the thing is, those people who were alive then, and they were in their heyday, their 30s or 40s or 50s, now in their 80s or 90s or whatever now, right? And there's still the people that are running Congress or running the Supreme Court to some degree or whatever, and running America to some degree. And so, yeah, that mentality will stay with us as long as those people are alive to some degree, because they're the ones ruling the world. But like I said, they're going to die out. They're going to die out. And the people from whose heyday were the 90s, like me, the early 2000s, those days, my 20s and my teen years, you know, those days will rule when it wasn't a big deal, gay people, when gay people began to have more visibility and whatever. So we will get our rights. It's just a matter of time. And that's the last thing I want to say about that is that, look, it doesn't matter if you think gay people deserve rights or not, because eventually we're going to get equality whether you like it or not. So if you don't like it, fuck you. That's what I say. Okay. Take another break, and then we're going to talk about some more things, and we'll be right back.
It doesn't matter if you love him or capital H-I-M. Just put your paws up, because you were born this way, baby. My mama told me when I was young, we're all superstars. She pulled my hair, put my lipstick on, in a glass of purple dry. There's nothing wrong with loving who you are, she said, 'cause he made you perfect, babe. So hold your head up, girl, and you'll go far.
Don't be a drag, just be a queen. Don't be a drag, just be a queen.
Give yourself prudence and love your friends. Subway can't rejoice the truth. In the religion of the insecure, I must be myself, protect my youth. A different law is not a sin. Believe capital H.
I'm beautiful in my way, 'cause I make no mistakes. I'm on the right track, baby.
Whether you're broke or evergreen, your black, white face, Chola descent, your Lebanese, your Orient. Whether life's disabilities left you outcast for leader tease, rejoice and love yourself today, cause baby, you were born.
No medication or violence.